The market for sports trading cards is booming.
Sports is a lot of people's escape. Why not invest in a player as opposed to investing in a stock?
The top 25 most expensive cards in history were sold in the last 2 years, including an Honus Wagner card sold for over $6.6 million.
A lot of us have been holding on these cards for 30 years, hoping someday that they'd be worth something, hoping someday I could say I told you so.
Big-time investors like hedge funds are also in on it. They've begun buying trading cards as alternatives to equities.
It's culture as an asset. It's nostalgia as an asset.
So, how did trading cards balloon into a multi-billion dollar industry? And why are both everyday people and big-name investors turning to trading cards as investment assets? This is Niche Markets, a series that examines small, lesser-known markets that, despite their size, punch well above their weight.
In front of us, we have a bunch of cards, one of them being as early as the 1934, a famous card called the Gaudi, all the way down to Honus Wagner and Joe DiMaggio. If we believe that they are authentic, we'll send them in to get graded.
To verify a card's authenticity and determine how much it's worth, today's card owners rely on a practice known as grading. Collectors send their raw or ungraded cards to grading agencies, where their cards will be examined and assigned a 1 through 10 grade. Card scores are based on 4 different factors: centering, corners, edges, and surface.
So we ended up getting them all graded. They all came back real. One is the lowest grade you can receive. That is as terrible as it comes. There's a crease right down the entire middle of it. Corners are all paled up, edges are all dinged up. This card is probably around a $100 to $200 card raw, but once you get it graded, it's real, it's authenticated, it's now a one. We now know the value of it's around $800 to $1,000. To know that its value is worth X or Y because of its grade is what really turned this hobby into what it is now, as a stock market.
In the past, buyers had to take a seller's word on the legitimacy of a card's condition. But today, thanks to grading companies like PSA, Beckett, and SGC acting as neutral arbiters of quality, a card's price is much easier to verify.
One of the things that my mom always said that I couldn't really have an answer for was, that card's not worth $20 until you get someone to give $20 for it. And that's no longer true.
Bert Duvaux, Jesse Duvaux, and Jeffrey Ferraro are the owners of Fresh Pulls, a trading card shop located in the outskirts of Boston. The three friends opened the store in May after making a small fortune auctioning cards online.
We did $2 million in sales. We should break the $3 million mark within the next month by the end of September.
Since the trio started their business in March of 2020, they've all left their jobs in the hospitality industry and seen their material circumstances transformed.
I used to work 70 hours a week in a kitchen and be absolutely miserable. Now I can work 150 hours here, and it doesn't seem like 150 hours.
Fresh Pulls' story is but one example of card owners striking it rich in today's market. Since the pandemic began, reports of former hobbyists digging up their old collections and discovering a windfall have not been uncommon. Sports cards have existed since the early 1900s, but in the 1980s and 1990s, prices for newer cards cratered after manufacturers flooded the market.
Ken Griffey Jr.'s his rookie card is known for being one of the most mass-produced cards, and it's just not valuable.
The pandemic also triggered a string of deals and acquisitions that have shaken up the industry. Earlier this year, the investment firm The Chernin Group, along with celebrities like Mark Cuban and Kevin Durant, invested $40 million in one of the industry's best-known auction houses, Golden Auctions. This July, Golden was acquired by the investment group Collectors Holdings.
It's an exciting time for everybody here at Golden. It's an exciting time for the industry as a whole.
Also in July, Blackstone acquired a majority stake in the grading company Certified Collectibles Group, which values CGC at more than $500 million.
These people have people to tell them where to invest their money. They're not telling them to invest billions of dollars into the card market for it to just collapse.
Right now I'm holding two of my most favorite cards. They both are a 1997 Kobe Bryant Precious Metal Gems, the red version. There are 100 of them in the world. This is a PSA 5.5, this one's a PSA 4.5. This card right here I bought for $13,000, is probably worth between $160,000 and $200,000.
Lior Avidar was an avid card collector when he was younger, especially for Kobe Bryant cards, but he didn't return to the hobby until 2016.
I went on eBay, And the first box of cards that I went and looked for was the EX2000. I had never gotten that Kobe Bryant green card that I was that I really wanted when I was young. And I saw that there were different price points. Like, some were selling for $30, and there was one that was selling for $3,000. And I was like, why is one $30 and why is one $3,000?
Avidar, who has a background in finance, saw opportunity in the inefficient way in which pricing was determined.
And I remember seeing that the probability, the expected value, was positive, meaning if I kept buying the boxes and probabilistically I will get the Kobe Bryant card and then I sell it on eBay, I'll make $10 to $20 a box.
After 5 years of buying and selling cards, Avidar turned his passion into a business. In March of 2020, Avidar launched Alt, which aims to be a sort of Coinbase for collectibles, where users can buy and sell cards just like more conventional assets. Alt brands itself as a modern financial institution that allows people to invest in things they're passionate about, just like stocks.
When you log into Alt, it feels a lot like Coinbase or Robinhood or Fidelity. In real time, you can actually see how much your portfolio is worth.
Similar to how Zillow uses its Zestimate figure to track home prices, Alt created the Alt value to track card prices.
The number one question when people start getting into cards is, how much are my cards worth? The whole point of the Alt value is to give people confidence around the values and just increase some of the transparency that exists in the ecosystem, but just hasn't been brought out and democratized on the internet so far.
Alt is just one of a new crop of digital services catering to the rapidly growing trading card market. Collectible and Dibs allow users to buy and trade fractional shares of cards. Star Stock brands itself as a stock market for sports cards.
All right, guys, good luck.
Fresh Pulls has made most of its money by hosting a relatively new type of online auction called case breaking.
Patriot Julian Edelman and a kid reporter. Nothing there to start.
Case breaking is essentially gambling on unboxing videos. A break involves groups of collectors co-investing in a case inside of which are packs of cards and then watching a live stream of the unboxing.
Peyton, my boy, man. Rookie! Nice card. That's how we start off. First box, mojo, baby. So there's a $2,000 box of NBA basketball. 10 of us spend $200, and we each get 3 random teams. So let's say you have the Celtics, the Knicks, and the Wizards. I open up the box. Every Celtics, Knicks, and Wizards cards in that entire box all goes to you.
Days later, collectors receive the cards they won in the mail.
Two packs left.
One of the things that people asked us at first, like, why would somebody pay you to open their cards? And it's not that they're paying us to open the cards, they're having an experience. Like, if you take the pack home and open it by yourself in your bedroom, you're alone. Like, when you do it with us, you're in a room full of your friends.
In the grand scheme of things, it's a casino. You're coming in here and gambling. Most of the people in this world love sports and fantasy football and gambling. Like, those are the things that aren't going anywhere. Joshua Kelly, rookie. Too bad that wasn't a damn Herbie. I don't see the card market going anywhere for a long, long time. Van Jefferson! Bad card! Purple star! Oh, that is bad. Dope.